Hi, Dr. Huntington here with you. And today we are going to look at one of the reasons why you should avoid eating so many grains and legumes. Now, this information is conveniently ignored by people, you know, that'll tell you that grains are part of a balanced diet. The overall problem is that grains wreak havoc on your gut. Now, the good news is that you can get plenty of nutrients and fiber from other foods that support your health without destroying your gut. And it's no secret anymore that when your gut health is compromised, every part of your body becomes susceptible to dysfunction and disease. First, the human body is not designed to consume and digest certain plants, especially the grains that have been grown and processed in the last 100 years or so. Now, generally speaking, grains are seeds, and seeds are intended to be cultivated in the ground to support the plant's reproduction and survival. So as an evolutionary protection mechanism, certain plants contain chemicals that are toxic to a predator. And these chemicals, known as gliadin and lectins, are also found in legumes, like certain vegetables and fruits, and cause massive damage to the intestinal lining of the gut. This damage to the gut lining causes permeability, known as leaky gut, and creates a way for substances to cross into the bloodstream that otherwise shouldn't be there. And this leads to a whole host of conditions that are linked to a leaky gut. Gliadin is a protein found in wheat gluten and in some other non-gluten foods such as oats. And gliadin is toxic to your immune system. It's especially dangerous because it boosts the production of a protein called zonulin. And zonulin regulates the gaps in the junctions between the cells that line your intestine. In other words, the amount of zonulin in your system will determine if the junctions in your gut lining are open or closed tight the way they should be. And of course, what you want is for them to be closed really tight. So when you eat gluten, so we'll take a look at the board here. So when you eat gluten or a gluten-free food that happens to contain gliadin, what happens is your zonulin level rises. Right? And then that is what's causing leaky gut. So if we've got our diagram here, and this is inside the gut, right? And this is your bloodstream out here. We'll put blood for out here. What happens is this increase in zonulin causes these junctions to no longer be tight. And you literally have holes or spaces for things like undigested food particles or bacteria to flow through and get into the blood. So what's happening here is the gliadin causes this increase in zonulin, right, that your body produces and opens up these junctions and causes this gut permeability that we talk about or call leaky gut. And this is a big problem because you don't want bacteria, metabolic waste, and undigested food particles in your bloodstream, right? There's supposed to be a barrier there. All that stuff is supposed to be kept in your gut, and only selective things that are supposed to get into your bloodstream are supposed to make that transition. So you want these junctures between your intestinal cells to be tight and not permeable. Now, lectins are another troublesome substance that some plants contain in very large amounts, right? And the current consensus is that these plants have these high levels of lectins to ward off predators, such as insects. Now, some of these lectins are neurotoxins and can actually paralyze a bug if it eats the plant. But of course, Mother Nature plays on both sides of the game, right? So many animals like birds and rodents, possibly other insects, you know, have had thousands of years to develop ways to deal with these lectins so that they can safely consume them. But humans, on the other hand, have been consuming unsprouted grains and legumes for, you know, a much shorter time. And so our digestive system has not yet really developed any way to safely deal with these lectins. When you consume foods that have a high level of lectins, the lectins damage your gut by actually tearing holes in the cells that line it. And these torn, dysfunctional cells leave you with a leaky gut. One type of lectin found in wheat is called wheat germ agglutinin, or WGA for short. WGA is especially potent and protects wheat from bacteria, yeast, and insects. In fact, over 40 studies on WGA have linked it to intestinal and autoimmune diseases and skin problems, as well as thyroid, pancreatic, and kidney cancer. So the first thing to know on this topic is that food which contains high levels of lectins will damage your gut lining and can lead to leaky gut. And that opens the door to a whole host of other problems, maybe the most common being autoimmune conditions. The second thing to know, is which foods are high in lectins. And what you want to do is to avoid consuming those foods or use special methods of food preparation which actually neutralize the lectins. And I'll cover that in another video. And then the last thing to know about lectins is that some people can tolerate them better than others. But for those who don't tolerate them well, the gut damage can lead to a long list of symptoms associated with leaky gut. So make sure that you know the symptoms of leaky gut so that you can identify the problem. Okay, until the next time, watch those high levels of lectins, and more importantly, watch more of my videos. And of course, give me a like or a thumbs up, to let others know that you found the information helpful. All right, I'll see you again soon.